When it was finally over after that tense day on Friday and the younger Tsarnaev was taken into custody, President Obama went before the cameras and he had something to say about the reporting of the Boston bombings.
In this age of instant reporting, tweets and blogs, you know, there's a temptation to latch on to any bit of information, sometimes to jump to conclusions.
FBI earlier in the week had also complained about inaccurate reporting. So this is an instance where the government is criticizing the media.
It's fun. And they're right. And, you know, they have the FBI issued a smashing statement about the thing we were just talking about before, saying, please check official channels. Of course, sometimes the government isn't too cooperative when the media knocks on their door as well. So I think that's a two-way street.
And after the mistakes earlier in the week that we have talked about in the last segment, I thought I saw a note of caution creeping into these discussions. And we pulled some sound from different networks to illustrate what I'm talking about.
A lot of this is, you know, it's conjecture and us trying to piece together and trying to figure out motivation, frankly, Brian. You know?
And we should just quickly point out that, as we saw with Newtown, people do crazy things. And before we leap to any conclusions of a political motive,
at this point, we have no reason to believe whether their religion or their place of origin has anything to do with their intentionality here. It's just detail provided by investigators. Keep that in mind.
Is that the sound of journalists pulling back and being careful?
Not only was it the sound of journalists pulling back, but if you landed on social media during that time, everybody was saying, please don't report things that aren't true. Right. Twitter grew up during this crisis, and it really showed that people didn't want to get it wrong this time.
We'll talk more about that in the next segment, but I also wanted to say that, you know, naturally we have focused on some of the things that went wrong. I think that during this week, as all these journalists invaded Boston, there was a lot of good reporting. There was a lot of compassionate reporting. There were interviews with eyewitnesses, interviews with people who were related to those who had been wounded. And we ought to tip our hat to the fact that this is something that television, with its leaving aside the excesses, can do very well.
Absolutely. And we saw that. I think the peak of that was Diane Sawyer at 8 o'clock Friday night. Fox was in opinion mode still, talking about speculation about if the family gets along okay. Sawyer's on the phone with the guy who found the body in the boat. And the description that was there, and the fact that she let that guest go. He said, you know, I see a strap cut. Then I see blood on the ground. Then I open up the tarp and I see a body. And you felt like, wow, that could be me. And you were so scared almost, like, hearing that story, because you're thinking, this is a monster that put a bomb next to an 8-year-old kid. And he could just detonate himself at any moment. So what would I do in that situation? That was journalism. That was hard journalism at its finest. And the fact that ABC's producers were able to get that guy on the phone, that was the shining moment.
And yet at the same time, we saw all of these experts rolled out. And I understand the value of having ex-detectives and FBI profilers and, you know, Tom Ridge, former head of Homeland Security. But you're also filling airtime. But a lot of them went the speculation route as well before we knew the identity of the bombers.
There was, and I think you'll find among conservatives in the country, a lot of anger that it was discussed earlier in the week. Oh, what could Patriots Day be symbolic here? You know, could this be a right-wing thing? I believe someone from NPR had conjectured to that effect. I did.
Chris Matthews started to say it's often right-wing extremists.
Exactly. Saw on the clip, right?
And so I think that there is some merit there. Although, if something happens on Patriots Day, I think you're licensed as a broadcaster to say, could this have something to do with Patriots Day? I think that we're all right with it.
What really makes me angry about this is that these are analysts and contributors who have been sitting in the corner, you know, since the last tragedy, not on TV talking about
it. You used to see them all the time during the Bush administration.
Right. And you don't see them anymore. And so there is something for them to be able to contribute. What I like to see them contributing is not conjecture, it's not speculation, but it is. This is what happened behind the scenes during 9/11. I was there. This could be happening. I like to know that stuff. I like to understand what the FBI and the police are doing.
What about all the pieces that are starting to be written, and they're all over the Sunday papers this morning, the profile of the Tsarnaev brothers?
So sick of it.
And what is their motivation, and how did they turn radical, and did the older brother influence the younger brother, and what about that trip to Chechnya?
Hey, does anybody remember 8-year-old Martin Richard? Who was that? That was the 8-year-old little boy who was blown up. All we are going to do now for the next week is focus on, we will know more about these people than we know these two boys than we know about our own relatives.
We
will
we
be
should.
Into
I think
their
we
mind.
Should.
I'm not saying a little bit isn't good, but I'm saying we have to remember the victims.
I think we should remember the victims, but we should know massive amounts about these two men. Massive
but
amounts.
Isn't there a danger, Eric? And I had the same feeling after Newtown,
I know,
and the same feeling after Columbine, that we are kind of glorifying the people who do this, not glorifying in the sense we're saying good things about them, but such an intense focus on them that it takes the spotlight away from those who were killed and wounded and maimed.
I don't think that that's our consideration. I think we need to know as much about the people who commit acts of terror in this country as we possibly can. And I don't think there's any, you know, I don't think we should be worried about where the spotlight falls. We need to know about these people.
I disagree, and I said it before. We do need to worry about where the spotlight falls. The media have an immense power over the minds of the American people. This is what you see day in and day out. And so you're focusing on the negative. You're focusing on the bad boys. What about the other people? What about moving forward? What about issues? How can we prevent this? What do we need to do in society?
Howie, one more positive that came out of this was the fact that there's nowhere to hide now. That because the media is so prevalent, that Twitter is so prevalent, that people can share information so easily, it is hard to hide now because pictures that used to be in a post office or in a newspaper
right.
now are everywhere.